Alleluia, Christ is risen. Alleluia, o Christu, o Vukile. Alleluia, Christus het opgestaan. Praise the Lord. Blessed be God, by whose love Jesus was raised from the dead. Hallelujah. For purity, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confess our sins with sincere and true hearts. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone, for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you. Pardon your sins and set you free from them. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray the collect for this day. Lord Jesus Christ, You transform the tomb of death into the womb of new life. Make us joyful witnesses of this good news, that all creation may be redeemed, restored, and reconciled. For you live and reign in the unity of the Blessed Trinity, one God in glory everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. Just a brief preface to the reading from the New Testament scripture. It's that our readers are at the moment quarantined in the Holiday Inn in Birmingham. And that is Alan and Verena Rogers. They have been living in South Africa since October 1976. And from that period, they have been members, gradually but eventually very active members of our cathedral congregation. And then about a week ago, they departed back to their homeland, England. And I had asked them to do the readings for today as they committed to. But when I visited them, I discovered that they would be, from the moment of arrival in Birmingham, would be quarantined for 10 nights and 11 days in the Holiday Inn right there at the airport in Birmingham. And I would imagine that there will be very little technical support. So Father Sean and I then went over to Bloubergstrand the next day and we recorded them. And so I hope that wherever you are, Verena and Alan, that you are able to see us watching you on this day.
Then Peter began to speak. I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts from every nation the one who fears him and does what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, announcing the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout the province of Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him.
We are witnesses to everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging on a cross, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all the people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people, and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of their sins through his name.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Thank you. be with you.
And also with you.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to St. John. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went towards the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes, but Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the Gospel of Christ.
May I speak in the name of God's beloved. A few years ago, I stood here in the cathedral parking lot talking to a priest who has the wonderful name of McGlory, Father McGlory. I must say, I would love to have a name like that and to introduce myself in that manner. And he told me a story about when he was a youngster in his 20s, living out in Grahamstown, today called Makana. And about a neighbor of his, whose name I also know, also a dear friend of mine. And the neighbor was working on the roof of their house when the security police arrived, and this is in the 1970s, and arrested him for his student activities in that town and in the region of the Eastern Cape. And then this fellow said to the police, but it's not only me, it's that fellow who lives in that house, we're in this thing together. And that is how Moglori and my other friend ended up sharing a detention time in King Williamstown. And it's only when they were in the cell together that Moglori learned about the generosity of information sharing on the part of his cellmates, who told him, I didn't want to be alone. There's two things that strikes me is the confidence of the friendship. That if I'm going into this thing, I don't want to be on my own. And Moglori, in relating the story to me, I can still hear the loud laughter on the parking lot as he told me that. And there was no anger. Just the pleasure of telling a story of a dark time and in about the peculiar and particular nature of friendship. And I met this fellow who shared the cell with Moglori when I went and did my training for the priesthood, and he had just come off Robben Island where he had been incarcerated for many years. And we also became good friends. And I think of Grahamstown, Makana, and I think the words that Jesus or the angel says in the Gospel of Mark to Mary Magdalene, where he says, and tell Peter and the others to go off to Galilee to wait for me there. And it is this very Galilee where one of the disciples, Nathanael, when told about Jesus of Nazareth, says, can anything good come out of Nazareth in the region of Galilee? We are a Easter people living in a Good Friday, perpetual Good Friday reality, with a solitary mandate of our baptismal promises to make every little place that we live an outpost of heaven. That is the mandate given to the Easter people. And in that prison cell, the tension time and the atrocities that came with that deprivation, two young men made their cell a little outpost where the Easter people reigned and were manifest. Moglori's mother worked in the town in domestic service. His younger brother, a lover of opera, eventually migrates southwards and ends living in Mitchell's Plain. And on Good Friday, I'm sitting listening to Grant accompanying the daughter of this man, Moglori's niece, singing a spiritual that references the question of the prophet Jeremiah, is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no balm in Gilead? And Gilead was known for its healing ointment. When the father of Joseph deploys his sons to seek relief in the period of famine, he sends balm from Gilead as a gesture, as a gift, as an offering of goodwill. But despite its healing and iconic association with the balm, the people of Gilead at a given time, during the time of the prophet Jeremiah, did not experience the qualities that were spiritual because the leadership were corrupt and the priests led by their own design and were deaf to the commands and the voice of Yahweh. And so he asked this question rhetorically, is there no balm in Gilead? And sensed this later from the lives of enslaved people in the southern parts of the United States of America comes an emphatic yes, there is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole and to make the sin sick well. There is a balm in Gilead. And they had taken their Good Friday reality of incarceration, of lifelong slavery, of being bonded to another in chains, whipped, laboring under the southern heat in the cotton fields and wherever they worked, both in the fields and in the domestic quarters of the master. And yet out of the religion of the master, the religion that was meant to remind them to turn the other cheek, they found an Easter anointing where they could sing, and we heard it on Good Friday, that there is a balm in Gilead. And when I listen to this young woman sing, there was a liquid anointing that I felt the Holy Spirit present in our gathering. In a time when the balming healing is lacking, where COVID prevails and is dominant, and there's an anxiety about a third wave, and can anything good come from Galilee? Can anything good come from a place known as Rocklands, Mitchell's Plain? She stood there and she testified beautifully in a mezzo-soprano, Daniel Speck, granddaughter of a domestic, the niece of a man who knew prison time, and the progeny of a father who loved opera. And the world opened, and she brought healing balm into our lives. When the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917 in Russia took place, The dialectic materialism of Marxist ideology was prevalent. And on a given day, the local commissar and his soldiers rounded up in a small village the inhabitants and took them to a field and over a long period lectured them in the benefits of socialism, of communism, exposed and ridiculed their ignorance in their belief, and very intently deconstructed their belief in God and in all the teachings of the church was laid waste, and a fatal silence prevailed. And then the Russian Orthodox priest stood up in his black garments, went to there where the commissar stood in front of his congregation, and lifted up his hands and said quietly, "Christ is risen." And at first, one voice, "He is risen indeed," and others joined until it was a choir of voices reaching into their history and into their faith in all its broken pieces and gathering into a healing balm. The proclamation that we make today, "He is risen, He is risen, He is risen indeed, indeed. He is risen," and they proclaimed it after their poverty and after their alienation, they grew together as a family. And as we live in this Good Friday reality, in a few seconds' time, we will renew the promises that were made for us and that we've repeated successive Easter days, that we will fight against sin, the world, and the devil. You and I will stand here under this roof, that God is alive, despite what is happening in our lives, and despite that what will happen. These are the moments our rallying defiance and humble assertion that He is risen. As Daniel Speckman testifies through voice and presence that there is a balm in Gilead, her roots tracing her to the Eastern Cape, to the ways of the Khoi and of the Amakosa. She is a progeny. And she stood there later at the high altar, accompanied by a youthful orchestra on the whole, but the demographics was white and black. It wasn't just a white orchestra, it wasn't just a black orchestra, it was everybody bringing together chords and notes into a rising harmony of love, a balm, an Easter message on that very solitary Good Friday. So is there a balm? Yes, we live it with our lives. Reach out, call somebody today, make a plan when you see somebody that is very destitute. Be that balm and be that answer to a prayer as we go about as an Easter people, creating little outposts of heaven wherever we are. Amen. We now invite the altar servers and those who they've conscripted to assist them to light the candles that are there. And as you see, they are lighting candles from the Paschal candle. So please, if you have a lighter, refrain from using it. It will come from the light of Christ. And the service for the renewal of your vows is found on page 7 of the booklet that you have on hand. So as your candle is lit, would you please stand? So, beloved, this water that I hold, it's in the container I hold in my hand, will be used to remind us of our baptism. So let us ask God to bless it and to keep us faithful to the Spirit He has given us. Father, we give you thanks for your gift of life-giving water. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you brought your people out of slavery in Egypt. And in the waters of Jordan, your Son was anointed with the Holy Spirit. And as he hung on the cross, water and blood flowed from his side. Through the waters of baptism, you delivered us from sin and raised us to newness of life. And we ask you now to bless this water to our use. May it remind us of our baptism, that renewed by your Spirit, we may rejoice with all who were baptized this Easter. Grant this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so, as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, we remember that through the Paschal mystery, we have died and have been buried with him in baptism. And in baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvelous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Let us therefore, on this festival day, renew our baptismal covenant. And I ask you, therefore, do you reject the devil and all rebellion against God? Do you renounce the deceit and corruption of evil? Do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and neighbor? Do you turn to Christ as Savior? Do you submit to Christ as Lord? Do you come to Christ the way, the truth, and the life? Sisters and brothers, I ask you to profess the faith of the church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father? Do you believe and trust in Jesus Christ? Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit? On this feast of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, do you affirm the faith in which you were baptized and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ? Beloved, this is a born-again moment. It's a born-again statement. And so I ask you, will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whatever and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all people, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you acknowledge Christ's authority over human society by prayer for the world and its leaders, by defending the weak, and by seeking peace and justice? May Christ dwell in your hearts through faith, that you may be rooted and grounded in love and bringing forth the fruit of the Spirit. And so receive now the sprinkling of the water as a reminder of your baptism.
Thank you. Let us pray. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, you are the light of the world. Inflame us with the light of your gospel, that we might be heralds of your peace in our warring world. Make us an Easter people, O Christ, and lead us by your light. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, you are the Word by whom and through whom all things are created and given life. Make us faithful stewards of the universe you have entrusted to our care, that we may cherish the bounty of the earth, the sky, and the sea, and preserve them for those who come after us. Make us an Easter people, O Christ, and inspire responsible stewardship within us. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, you are the bread of life. Nourish the church with your life-giving word, that together with Thabo, our Archbishop and Metropolitan, Joshua, our Bishop, and all your people, we may provide bread for hungry bodies and faith for seeking souls. Make us an Easter people, O Christ, and feed us with your word. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, you are our way, our truth, and our life. Be with us and all who follow you in the way. Deepen our devotion to your truth and fill us with your love, life. Guide the leaders of all the nations in your ways of justice and freedom, truth and peace. Make us an Easter people, O Christ, and keep us in your way. Lord Jesus Christ, you are the good shepherd who gave your life for the sheep. Recover the straggler, bind up the injured, strengthen the sick, and protect those who are healthy. Make us an Easter people, O Christ, and give us your saving help. Risen Lord Jesus Christ, you are the resurrection and the life. We give you thanks for all who have lived and believed in you, those whose lives have been examples to all of us, those whom we have loved but no longer see. Raise us with them to eternal life with you. In mercy, hear our risen Lord. Accept our prayers and our souls. Amen.
In our prayers also, I encourage you to pray for Walter Luning. In this moment that he's struggling so strongly with the condition of the body and of the spirit, and we also pray for his beloved Hilary. We also pray for strength of body and spirit of Auntie Millie Eckstein and for Chris and the family at this time. We are mindful of those who will not be at table today with us at lunch. We pray for our loved ones of faithful memory. These we ask and pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Friends, just a warm greeting and well wishes for this Easter from Archbishop Thabo and Mama Lunge, and also on behalf of our Bishop Joshua and his spouse Joan Lowe, and myself and Benita, and our wardens Catherine de Jong and Arthur Martin, and our council. I wish you and all your loved ones a most blessed, a joyful, and a safe Easter this day. Would you please stand? And so may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Maubongwe wena nkosi, sikhowendala yonke ngenxa yokulunga kwakhe. Sinesisonka sisinikelayo, isonka esinikwe kumhlaba nesenziwe zizandla zomntu. For us it becomes the bread of life. Here God van die hele skepping, geseend is u. Deur die goedheid kan ons hierdie wyn offer. Dit is die vrug van die wynstok en die werk van mense hande. For us it becomes the cup of salvation. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and indeed our duty and joy, Lord and Heavenly Father, God Almighty and Eternal, always and everywhere to give thanks to Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. Because through him you have created everything from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you delivered us from the slavery of sin when you gave in to be born as man, to die on the cross and to rise again for us. Through him you claimed us as your own people when you enthroned him with you in heaven, and through him sent out your Holy Spirit, the giver of life. And now we give you thanks for his glorious resurrection from the dead. By his death, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us eternal life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we acclaim you and declare the greatness of your glory. We praise you now and forever, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Siveba ukenkana wako Kristu inkosi yetu. Ngayamke lambulela nombonga esiwinikilayo. Utumele umoya wako owingwele pezu kwetu. Na pezu kwezi zipo sisonkene wine. Kono kuzezibe kumzimba, negazi lake kuti. Wati nkobusuka wininkelwa ngabo wa tabata isonka. Waza akuba bulele kuwe wasiqekeza. Wabanika bafundi baki esiti. Tabata ni nitle, lo kumzimba wamo nikelelwa nina. Oku kwenzeleni ukudikumbula. Kananjala weva kwesitlo sangu kutlwa tabata intebe. Waza akubebulele kuwe, wabanika yesiti. Sela nikuyanonke, kubaliligazi lamnu ngopisho omcha alipalalela nina nabaninzi. Ukuze izono zikolelwe gamwa kwesho onke, enisi kuba niselo kuyo. Oku kwenzeleni, uku dikumbula. And so we proclaim the mystery of faith. Heilige Vader, met die gaves uit u hand vier ons, u mense, die een volmaakte offer, Christus onze Heere, sy opstanding in die dode en sy opwaart naar die hemelse heerlijkheid. Genadige Heere, neem ons aan hom aan, al is ons onwaardig, zodat ons wat deelneem aan die lichaam en bloed van die Seun nou en dier die eeuwe een mag wees met alle gelowiges. Vader, gee dat terwyl ons wag op die wederkoms van Christus ons verlosser, in die heerlikheid en triomf van sy koninkryk ons daagliks mag toeneem in gelykvormigheid aan sy beeld. Met wie en in wie en deur wie in die krag van die Heilige Gees alle eer en heerlikheid aan U gegee word, almagtige Vader, deur die hele gemeenskap op die aarde en in die hemel deur die eeue heen, nou en vir ewig. And so as Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. So draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. Behold who we are. I invite you now to join me in this act of spiritual communion as we say the prayer of the Animi Christi. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, refresh me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Let me never be separated from you. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me and bid me come to you, that with your saints I may praise you forever and ever. Amen. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out into the world, the power of the Holy Spirit, to love and work to your praise and glory. God bless our world, guard our children, guide our leaders, and give us peace. For Jesus Christ's sake, amen. And the blessing of the one holy and undivided Trinity be with you and remain with you always. Congregation, would you please be seated? Just two things on my side. Firstly, to for those who were able to make a contribution to my Easter offering. Thank you very much. I now can at least afford to pay for at least one hubcap of the red Audi that I'm planning to buy in about 4 years' time. But thank you very much. I appreciate it. The times are lean, and thank you for sharing what you have. And then also just to the musicians and crowd behind us, they are from my intel. My ecumenical nose tells me there's a new apostolic and there's a Moravian. Now tell me, am I right? They're uncertain. But thank you very much. Please stand.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia.